Hello and welcome to the first episode of A Brief History. Today's episode, The Beatles. Now you may be wondering, why The Beatles? Doesn't everyone already know everything about them? Well, if you've watched American Idol, you'll know that apparently there are people out there who have never even heard a single Beatles song in their life. So this is for those people. Ready, set, go! Liverpool, England, 1960. A group of young men with relatively big noses came together to form a band with the goal of being awesome. These men were John Lennon, Stuart Sutcliffe, who may or may not have been the world's first emo, Paul McCartney, George Harrison, and Pete Best. Inspired by 50s rock and roll and skiffle, which a music teacher of mine once referred to as skittle, they began to work towards following their dreams. Eventually, Sutcliffe left to become an artist, and Paul McCartney took over the bass duties. Similarly, Pete Best got the boot and was replaced by Ringo Starr, a drummer with an impressively large nose. With this lineup in hand, the band really started to kick off. Racking up hit after hit after hit, they soon became bigger than any artist, like ever, creating a phenomenon known as Beatlemania, which involved movies, cartoons, and of course sold out shows around the world. Now, for the first few years of their mainstream popularity, their music was very simple, catchy pop music. Then, Sgt. Pepper happened. And by that, I mean then, drugs happened. Sgt. Pepper was an album so completely different and weird that it skyrocketed the band to a whole new level of popularity. The Beatles had decided to stop touring, so they made Sgt. Pepper and the majority of their subsequent albums with the mindset of never having to recreate them live. So they got weird. Eventually, infighting, creative differences, and a slightly tone-deaf girlfriend drove the band apart. However, right before they disbanded, they gave a spontaneous surprise performance on the roof of the Apple Building. This performance is arguably one of the most famous concerts ever. After the band's breakup, John Lennon had a huge solo career, only to be shot in 1980. Harrison, who had a slightly less impressive solo career, died of cancer in 2001. McCartney still sells out arenas to this day, despite his alleged barefoot death upon the release of Abbey Road. And Ringo, well, he's still got a pretty big nose. An impressively large nose.